Over the past 6 or so years, I've been working as a consultant in no-code databases, in the cloud, building things from scratch, and there's this one feature that I've always wished was available, and it's not available in any tool that I've ever used until today. I really couldn't believe it, that this feature is available inside of SmartSuite, the ability to dynamically condition how you're accessing data through a linked record. What I mean here is when I have a linked relationship between multiple different things inside of my SmartSuite account, I can choose how data flows through on that linked relationship in granular ways that you could hardly even imagine if you have been using no code for any amount of time. In this video, I'm gonna be breaking down exactly how powerful this is with a couple of different use cases. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. Of course, SmartSuite is at the forefront of our favorite no-code tools, and it is possible for you to start saving up to 20 hours per week if you know your way around no-code tools like SmartSuite to help you get organized and automated so that those repetitive tasks start happening automatically in the background. Before we get into it, I want to first invite you to join me for a free automation training. You can grab that training at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. I will include links wherever you found this video. This training is going to walk you through the fundamental pieces of building automation so that you can start reclaiming your time with no-code tools. All right, now that that's out of the way, let's hop on into the heart of things. We have got to talk about this amazing linked conditional feature. The way that we link records in SmartSuite is unlike any application I have seen before and probably ever will see, frankly, because the way that they handle this is truly next level. It is best in class for no-code tools, hands down. I think you'll agree once you see what I'm gonna show you here. Follow along in your own SmartSuite account, go ahead and open it up. And if you don't already have SmartSuite, grab our affiliate link below to set yourself up with a free trial and get moving in there. Let's go ahead and hop on into my screen, and I will first start by outlining the database that we have built here. We are in a solution called invoicing. Pretty straightforward stuff. I have companies on my company's app. Of course, I know who my company is. I've got three companies right now: Acme, Beta, and Delta. I have a website link. So this is, you know, the example data that we're using here for this particular company. And then of course, a company has one or more contacts also in our database. So we have a different application here for contacts, and we're linking to contacts here. Now, I also have invoices. Now, invoices aren't really particularly important for our specific example here. What I really care about here is the fact that I have three different things: company, contact, and then whatever the other thing is. It could be projects, it could be invoices, it could be anything, frankly. But I have a third application that I need to link to. And you'll see why this is important in just a moment. Also note that I have an account executive, or an AE, and here this is an actual SmartSuite user. So I'm able to choose a user inside of my SmartSuite account and link them here by selecting them inside of this field. Now, these are two different things I want to demo for you, so we're going to take it a step at a time. But right now we want to focus on that link to contacts. So flipping into our second application, I have contacts, a bunch of sample data here, except for, of course, myself, the first contact. Here we have the full name, we have a phone number, and we have an email for that contact. Now, we also have a link to invoices. This is gonna matter in just a moment. So the contact links to an invoice, but so does the company. And then lastly, I'm also looking up the account executive. This is just a lookup field that says, hey, if an account executive is assigned to the company, I want to look it up here. So if I were to flip back to companies, we're going to see that I'm assigned to Acme, which has one contact, and I'm assigned to Delta, which has two contacts, Kieran and Tara. Well, if I flip into contacts, of course, I'm going to see myself as the assigned user for that account, right? Because I'm assigned to the company. Well, I'm looking that up here. So here I am. I am the AE in charge of Tara because of the fact that Tara is associated with Delta. So hopefully this schema makes sense so far. Now we're gonna go one layer deeper for this to really get cool. Now I'm in invoices. Inside of invoices, I've linked an invoice to a company. Now the other stuff on this invoices application doesn't matter. The total of the invoice, the line items, I don't care about any of that. What I care about is the link to the company for our example. So here I am assigned to Acme. This particular invoice is going to Acme, but I need to send it to a representative at Acme. So I want to link to contacts. But here, if I click in and I say, hey, show me the contact, well, now I have a list of all the different folks in my contacts application. And I want to make sure that if I'm sending this invoice to Acme, that I can only choose contacts from Acme. This sounds so deceptively simple, right? And yet, we can't do this with any other no-code tool except for SmartSuite. Here's how we set it up. Inside of this linked relationship to contacts, I'm going to go into the details here and go to the advanced settings. Inside of my advanced settings, in the upper part here of my settings, I have my fields. I have a sort, so I can assign an order to how people are showing up here. If I wanted to, for example, I could say, I want to see you in alphabetical order by title. So now we see that all the A's are showing up at the beginning and then the B's and the C's, etc. Okay, that's nice. But what I want to focus on is this filter. Now, normally when we apply a filter in other database tools, we can't filter things dynamically. But here inside of SmartSuite, I can actually filter these contacts based on the company that is also linked in this record. Check it out. In my filter, I'm going to say that I only want to look at wherever the link to companies is exactly, and here I can access dynamic data. I can say, give me a dynamic filter where I'm bringing in my link to companies. So what this means is that I want to filter in contact information only where the link to companies field is exactly, for the contact, the same ID, the same record that we're showing right here. Or in plain English, I only want to see the contacts that are assigned to the company that we are sending this invoice to. How cool? Let's hit save here and save those settings and update this field. Now that I've done that, when I click on link to contacts, remember there's only one contact assigned to Acme Co., a contact named Gareth. Well, if I click here, that's all I see. I cannot assign a contact here unless they are linked to or related to that company. Let's check out Beta Co. Let's flip into the companies. Here's Beta. It's assigned to Kathleen Snow, Georgia Snyder, and Brianna Fields. Well, if I go back to my invoices, what am I gonna see when I look at the contacts? I'm only gonna see Brianna, Kathleen, and Georgia in alphabetical order, thanks to the way I applied my sorting here. But the key takeaway is that filter. The fact that I'm only bringing in contacts that are related to a company and it's dynamic. If I were to create a new invoice here, whatever that invoice is, let's give it a number, 1, 2, 3, 6. Well, if I were to go and assign this to a company, let's go ahead and bring it into Delta. Now I'm only going to see those contacts that are associated with Delta. This all has to do with those advanced settings that we applied. Again, we got there by going into the advanced settings for the link to contacts, and we applied a filter here that said the company link is exactly the link to company's value. This is a dynamic filter that we can't do in any other no-code tool. Pretty epic, but it doesn't stop there. Let's take a look at a second quick use case here. Let's flip back and remind ourselves about our assigned users. If I go back to my companies, again, we assign an account executive. This is a user inside of SmartSuite, not to be confused with a different set of data, like I have a contacts application here. So now I've assigned myself, the user Gareth, to two different accounts, the Acme company, and also Delta Incorporated. So now I can go and I bring in that lookup field that we talked about earlier. I look up the account AE. Lookup AE, again, this is a lookup field that's looking at my companies and bringing in the account executive. Now that we've got that established, let's flip into invoices. Maybe I have a use case where I say, I only want my users to be able to create invoices for accounts that they are assigned to. They can't send an invoice to somebody who's not a contact that's related to an account that they're working with. Well, how do we do that? Same idea here. Inside of the advanced settings for my link to contacts, I can apply a filter and change out the one I had previously. Instead, I'll apply a new filter And I will say that that lookup AE, this field again lives inside of my contacts application. That lookup account executive is exactly, and here's where I can say current user. And now I will only be able to, as a user, see the people that are assigned to accounts that I'm assigned to. Let's see it in action. Here I'm going to save. And when I open up and update this field, when I look at my contacts that are available, they're not associated with the contacts to the company any longer. Now these are contacts that are associated with accounts that I am a member of, accounts that have been assigned to me as a user. So let's refresh our memories. If I go to companies, I am assigned to Acme, which has the user Gareth Pronovost, and I am assigned to Delta, which has two other users, Kieran and Tara. So when I'm in invoices, I should only be able to see those three people, Gareth as a contact, Kieran as a contact, and Tara as a contact. When I click on this, that's exactly what I see, because these are the people that are associated with accounts that I am assigned to as a user. This allows us to do amazing new things directly inside of our SmartSuite accounts based on users who are logged in, but also to filter dynamically based on linked relationships between our data. This, again, is deceptively simple. It's something that you would assume we could do in just about any no-code tool, but we can't until now, thanks to SmartSuite and their amazing relationships. I hope you got a ton of value out of this video. Do let me know in the comments below how you're going to be using this, and of course, keep on building.